Last night, I just got back from the Keepers of the Old Ways. It was late last night. Not late last night, but it was late enough last night. I was kerpooping. So I didn't want to do anything last night. However, today we are back at it. We are back in the grind. I am feeling more rested, rejuvenated, relaxed. We're ready to go ahead and start picking up on our daily grind. That includes feeding the animals. And a lot has changed around here since last we toured our property. Whoa. As I told you we were going to do while I was gone on my trip, the two breeding mamas and the boar have been butchered. We were not able to sell the boar. Granted, I didn't try that hard. I placed one ad, one might argue overpriced ad. But at any rate, we called the butcher. We talked to the mobile butcher guy that comes out and does the killing. I got some mixed reviews, but the guy who does the butchering said that usually it's fine, as well as my husband's coworker who has had it done before. He said everything was totally fine. So we decided it's evident as soon as you start the butchering. And they did this thing where they take a piece of fat and they microwave it, and they can tell what the smell is to it. So they did that and everything turned out fine. So we went ahead. Those two don't get along. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and feed these guys so they'll be a little bit more quiet. Now that they're a little bit more quiet, I did list 6 of these for sale just this morning. Girl, you got knocked up, didn't you? I think we have one pregnant female cat. She is bloated and she has not eaten yet today. At least not by us. 6 of those are listed for sale. Hopefully they will go very quickly so we can cut down on our feed bill, at least for a little while, until the 4 that we keep grow out. I can't remember what I was saying about the boar, but at any rate, we decided to have the boar butchered and we just turned him into hot sausage. So as far as we can tell, everything with that should be turning out just fine. And hopefully these little piglets will sell. But we need to go ahead and take care of the chickens, take care of the ducks, empty out my truck. And then I have a ton of errands that I have to run today. After my husband got home from work last night, he told me that we need pig food, or we need animal feed in general. So I'm gonna have to go pick that up. I have to run into our big city and place some orders and pick up some stuff, because I have a lot of starts that desperately are in need of being up potted. And I'm gonna take one thing off my plate, and I'm just gonna buy organic potting mix from Costco, and we're just gonna do it that route. I'm also gonna see, because I know that a lot of the starts that I have, I'm gonna try and give away and sell, and I don't wanna give away my bootstrap farmer pots. So I need to get some, you know, pretty standard thin pots that I can feel comfortable parting ways with. Or I don't know if I can find that in our big city, but I'm gonna try. So, oh gosh, there's a lot of stuff I gotta get done today, but mostly I'm gonna be on the road, unfortunately. I just drove to southern Alabama, and oh, I need to get more hoses too. I might get those today. Obviously, I don't want to run to a town with a truckload full of stuff already. I don't have to pick up a whole lot, but, you know, it's a pain in the butt. You gotta be worried about your load, if it's gonna fall out. And anybody who's ever taken a solo road trip knows what the cab of your truck looks like when you get home. While I was at Keepers of the Old Ways in Alabama, one of my neighbors was David the Good, and he's got some awesome plants. So I ended up getting two elderberries from him, one blueberry, it's like a wild type blueberry, and two black cherry trees. Also, Mayim Farms traded me and I got another elderberry plant. And if that wasn't enough, you are so pregnant, girl. I think she got a litter going on in there. She is chubby in her belly. Anyways, while I was at Baker Creek last week, I also got some other stuff that I'll share with you when we get inside, but I'm just gonna keep emptying out my cab and then I'll see you in there. Another thing that happened while I was in Alabama is this. There's actually like 25 of them. They're all huddled underneath that plate. But we have the next batch of chicks ready to go. I'm very excited. Like I said, lots of stuff's happening. So I got two of these at Baker Creek. I got two of these fairly large blackberry plants. Yes, I got them over a week ago and they're still in bags. So hopefully they'll survive. Looks like they still got a little bit of water left in them. But I got a total of 8 of these kind of smaller blueberry starts. 4 of them were pink lemonade and 4 of them were something else I don't remember the variety of. And then I got 3, looks like these definitely are worse for the wear, but I'm sure they'll be fine when I plant them probably tomorrow. But I got 3 boysenberry, I think it was, and 2 golden raspberries. So I'm very excited about that. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cook some food and then I'm gonna hit the road. One other thing that I realized that I need to make sure that I do is fix this camera. I don't know why it didn't even occur to me that I could take it to a camera repair shop and they could fix the trap door that has been that won't stay shut. So I'm gonna take that in town with me. Hopefully they won't charge me an arm and a leg. So I'm gonna do that and then I'm gonna meet you back here this evening and I'm gonna talk about some other stuff business-wise that has seemed to make a change. I know that all you guys are gonna be super excited, the ones that have been praying for me, I really appreciate it. So I'm gonna share that with you guys when I get back. We're back home. Got pretty much all the errands done that I wanted to get done, except for one, and I forgot to get little sample cups for while I was at the market, but I can just order that on Amazon. It's not a big deal. So I got stuck in a doom scroll for an hour or so after I got home, so we don't have time to do as much as I hoped, but we are going to up pot these guys. Well, we're gonna pot some of them and then because none of them are actually in pots. We're gonna pot them. I can't remember if I mentioned earlier, but I'm totally taking the easy way out right now. And we're gonna go with some Miracle-Gro. It's organic, it's what they have at Costco. So this is what we're gonna be using here. And since I do anticipate doing quite a lot over the next few days, I'm just gonna park this wheelbarrow in my greenhouse and kind of leave it be. Pretty much all I'm gonna be up potting today is just those the berry bushes that I got. The thing that I wanted to talk to you guys about that I'm very excited about is since the last time that I talked to you guys about it, there has been further movement with the health department and I'm very excited. I should be meeting with the gal that I'm working with sometime this week and she's gonna kind of help me, or she's gonna go over my HACCP plans. She already has them in hand. I sent them all to her. So hopefully she will have had the opportunity to kind of go over them and then she can help me further hone them in and get them just right. Very good news on that front. So things are kind of moving along and I'm very excited about that. I've kind of come up with all the plans of how I'm gonna kind of manufacture things and see how the approval process goes, see how long it takes. I still don't have a clue how long it's gonna take, but we are actually moving forward with it, which is very exciting. The first step with it is just gonna be getting approved to sell at farmers markets in my local larger city. And then after that, we'll kind of move through the various other steps. There's different levels of requirements and different inspections and things that have to happen in order to sell at like wholesale to stores or to like online sales. There's different levels that are required. So the first step is just getting into the farmer's market so that I can start, or getting into a particular farmer's market so I can start making more sales, start building up capital, and then kind of start moving on from there. So there's a bunch of clumps in this dirt, so. Need to get a narrower table for in here, or a different chair. Either one would work. That's not gonna work, I know that. So I think it makes pretty good sense this thing's crooked, but whatever. We're just gonna go with the flow, keeping it simple today. But I think it makes sense to up-pot these things into these big, I think these are 5-inch pots, because I think it'll be a little bit before I'm ready to put them in the ground, and I wanna give them lots of room to grow and flourish. I believe these are thornless blackberries. I could be wrong, but I'm definitely hoping they are, because that would be awesome. I probably should not have filled these up already. I'm really getting excited and kind of hopeful for the future, and hopeful that something will come of this. We'll see. But most definitely, like with all the products that I'm making, I definitely try and take conscious effort to use really safe products. Most of the stuff that I use, all the stuff that I use for my kombucha and my John is organic, but I source organic like vegetables and stuff, which I'm not currently making right now. I source all the vegetables and stuff like that as organically as possible and as locally as possible. I don't really know how to spread these things out, so we're not gonna. I'm kind of hoping that with my attention to kind of the finer details, like trying to avoiding plastic whenever it's possible. Like I don't ferment anything in plastic, but you know, some of my pouring pitchers and the lids, unfortunately, that I had to get for the new jars, which I forgot to show you while I was in town today. I'm sorry, but I got a half pallet of new jars. The new style. I've always used the kind of beer bottles style jars, which is actually comes in pretty handy at market, at like festivals and fairs and stuff, because you know, people walk around with beer bottles, it draws attention, and then they ask about it. But I figured it was time to upgrade to a different style of bottle, and it's one that's local. It's actually, well, local-ish, I should say. They're local-ish. How do you separate all these things out? I wonder how to do that. I'm gonna look how to divide blackberry plants. I don't want to deal with that today, so we're not going to. I'll just get some of this dead stuff off, because it's been in a bag for a week. A week? A little more than a week. A couple more days longer than a week. As far as the garden goes, I'm still planning on doing a lot in the garden. Robert is gonna be helping a lot in the garden. Last year, he thought that I just wanted to do it myself, and he kind of did his thing, and then I was doing my thing, and then I wasn't doing my thing. And I'm not sure, I don't know, we didn't communicate very well on that. So we have had some conversations about it, and he's gonna be out there helping me trim up the tomatoes and do all the things on his days off, and whenever he's able to, so. We should be able to do pretty good teamwork on that one. And you know, my son, he can help out somewhat. He's not doesn't have a clue how to garden, so it's not like he'll be very helpful when it comes to that. But with other things, he can be helpful. He can, you know, move soil around, and you know, if I show him how to do something, he can duplicate it. Assuming that all of this stuff goes through as it seems it will, and as I'm hopeful it will, I'm gonna have less time to kind of spend around here. My content will definitely be a lot more vlog centric, which is what I want anyways, is what you guys have illustrated very, very plainly, that you guys enjoy vlogs as well, especially over like more the how-to style. So I listen. I'm doing it. I'm working on it. So, I didn't write on these which one is which. It's gonna be a surprise. Surprise! I'm gonna go with the ones with the pink leaves are the pink lemonade. That's what I'm gonna double down on that one. I think that's what it's gonna be. I'll just kind of be bringing you along for my journey. I'll bring you along to some events that I go to as I'm able to. You know, I can't bring you guys along with me to everything. But, you know, the events that I'm able to, I will. Look at that. Getting moldy, darn it. And you know, just kind of the process of just building everything up, because it's going to be a big process. We'll just kind of see how it goes as we do things, you know. but I'll be bringing you along for it. And of course, we're still gonna be doing gardening videos. We'll still be doing fermenting videos. We'll still be doing, you know, as I'm kind of learning and gaining knowledge in Korean natural farming, because I think that the Korean natural farming is gonna be a really key component in me being able to keep up with the garden. Because it's one of those things where it's not super hands-on. It's not like a lot of active stuff. Like it's you get everything going, and then once you kind of get everything going, to some degree, obviously it's not no work by any means, but like a lot of it kind of helps to take care of itself. And it may not be the first year, but you know, as things grow and gets healthy, you know, you're making your own inputs, you're making your own nutrients, you're inoculating your soil with all kinds of wonderful bacteria and yeast and fungi and protozoa and just all the things that your soil really needs. I already have one. It's not like a Korean natural farming technical input. I think it's more of a like a Jadom type thing, which is the author of Korean Natural Farming. It's his son. I'm not sure exactly where it comes from, but it's fermenting chicken poop, which I made and I was filming. I was bringing you guys along for me, stirring it up every single day. And then promptly 2 weeks ago, I forgot about it. And it's just been sitting there since. So y'all know you don't follow me for how to figure out how to do things perfectly, because I don't do anything perfectly and I don't even try really. But you figure out like, how much can I really screw this up and it still be successful? I'm your girl. I will figure out how much you can screw something up. And I will let you know, is it really that important if you do it exactly as it should be? How beautiful is this? I'm your girl if you want to know how much to screw up. So yeah, that's kind of the plan. That's kind of what we got going on moving forward. Pink lemonade. I'm just going to leave these suckers outside. I'm really excited now that I have these. I have plans, okay? For those of you who watch kind of my garden dig videos, one of my plans is there's in between separating some of my gardens, there's like a slope to it, and I'm gonna plant these on the slope because I can't really plant much of anything else on the slope, but I have a feeling that these will do just fine. I'm a cheater. I'm not really a cheater. I feel like if when you're in a really busy period of your life, if you can take something off of your plate, like purchasing soil instead of taking the time to make your own. And it doesn't take that much time to make your own, but it's like, it's just one of those things. It was like one thing off my plate that I don't have to think about, you know? Like, it just gave me a sigh of relief, you know? And they were on sale at Costco. I think they were like, it was like a 50, I think it was a 50 cubic foot bag. I'm not sure, but anyways, it's a very large, it's a Costco size bag, and it was like $8. Why wouldn't I do that, you know? This is so fun. It's so easy. I love it. Get my hands back in the dirt. It's been like 2 weeks since I've done this, and I'm very happy about it. Okay, I think I only have room for two more pots in here. Right. Oh, nope, I can fit all four. Have any of you guys ever, do you guys have experience with using shelves in your greenhouse? Like, because I've heard that inside of a greenhouse, kind of the light that helps things grow, like it's like projected. Like it doesn't have to be just a single layer all the time. Like maybe when they're smaller, I'm gonna have to look this up, but I feel like I wanna put a shelf out here so that I can get more starts out here. Because just this one table here, I mean, I might get 10 flats. And I have a lot more than 10 flats worth of tomatoes, so I'll tell you that. Once they're up potted, it's gonna be a lot. So if I can save space by throwing some shelves out here, I'm gonna do it. But I need to look it up first because I don't wanna risk ruining all my hard work, you know? Oh, and also I didn't find a greenhouse. I didn't really look for a greenhouse store, supply store either. I figure most of the stuff that I'm doing, I'm just gonna be giving away to friends, and I can just ask them to give me back my pots. You know, any other pot, like if it was this style pot, I could not care less. You know, but if it was, you know, bootstrap farmer, like, you know, it's bootstrap farmer. I don't just give away my bootstrap farmer pots, you know? So I think in the next video, we'll be up potting tomatoes and kind of doing a little bit of garden maintenance. I wanted to kind of bring you along for like a chill kind of day. of recovering from 2 weeks of self-imposed madness and just trying to get my rhythm back, try and find a good routine for myself. I definitely still need to do more tidying up in here, but I'm not overly concerned about it. That's broken. And I just need to water those in. I'll probably water them in with the fertilizer, like fish emulsion or something. Another thing that I really want to get done, hopefully before the end of the week, there's a couple of Korean natural farming inputs that I really want to make. There's one involving eggshells, which is like bioavailable calcium, which is super important for tomatoes. So I want to get that one done, because we have like a literal garbage bag full of eggshells that we need to do something with. And it'd be nice to be able to process it and get it in, you know, like a liquid form, something that's able to be used on the garden. And there's like a oriental herbal nutrient. I really want to get started making IMO, but I've been procrastinating on that one for no apparent reason whatsoever. It's pretty simple. I guess I'm procrastinating because I need to make the cedar box. I have the cedar. I can make it. I have the cedar. I'm capable of making it. It looks very simple. I have what I need, but I just need to actually make it. Procrastinator supreme right here. I'll tell you what. Okay, so I think these are boysenberries. Where didn't I write on these bags? I wrote on my husband's bags that I got for him. I didn't. Oh, I took pictures though. I did take pictures. I just remembered. The unknown blueberry variety is a Chandler. Yes, boysenberries. And I remember that I got 3 of the boysenberries because they were $3, and I only got 2 of the raspberries because they were 4. That was my thinking at the time. Because while I wanted to get plants, I did not want to spend a small fortune on them. And these ones were from Baker Creek, like from actual Baker Creek. Because at their festivals, they obviously sell plants. Good plants too, reasonably priced. And then the ones that I got that I showed you earlier, those ones I got from at the Keepers of the Old Ways event. Most of them were from David the Good, because he was my neighbor, and I didn't do a whole lot of exploring at the event, so why not just buy them from your neighbor, right? I think probably, okay, well, so we're already past our forecasted last frost date, because I mean, even beyond the last frost, you don't want to plant your tomatoes like right after your expected last frost. You don't want to put them in the ground, but if I can make sure to get this window closed up, close up the door overnight, get a heater in here, I can keep it warm enough. Because the tomatoes still need it to be relatively warm overnight, not just not frozen. But I have a lot of other stuff that can be just not frozen. Like I've got like kale and all kinds of stuff. 40 is the very lowest in the forecast. And it looks like next week, towards the end of next week, it's gonna be lows in the 60s. So, home stretch, you guys. Home stretch. I'm expecting probably middle of May is when I'll plant my tomatoes, and then like probably beginning of June, I would imagine, beginning to mid June, I'll get my potatoes or peppers in the ground, which I'm very excited about. And then I'm thinking possibly there's a local festival that's going on. I think it's May 4th. It's called Mayfest in my local town here, Mountain Grove. And it didn't even occur to me that I should sign up for that to be a vendor, but I did send them an email, so we'll see if they end up getting back to me. I might be selling at that one, which would be really cool, because then I could use what I make there to buy the trellises that I need for the tomatoes. I don't know how to spell boysenberry, but it doesn't really matter. We're going phonetic here. Maybe it's right, maybe it's not. Welcome to the English language. As soon as May comes around, it's kind of go time. In a lot of different ways. In the garden, that's market season, festival season picks up, so like, I'm gonna be a busy girl. I like being busy. As long as I maintain like my sanity, I don't like being bored. I don't like sitting around being bored, watching TV. Like, I enjoy doing things, and I think that's why I have such a tendency to experience burnout, because like, I enjoy so much that I forget to take a step back and maintain myself, you know? And then I also forget that, hey, sometimes I need to ask for help, you know? like whether it's, you know, for my husband, like he'll offer and then I'll be like, oh no, I got it. And then, you know, 2 weeks later, I totally crash and burn and I'm just like, why didn't I just accept his help that he offered, you know? I've done that many times. Hate to say it, but that's just the way I am sometimes. Needless to say, I just need to ask for help when I need it. And accept it sometimes when it's offered. I don't know if this guy is gonna make it. It's brown from here to here on both stems. Here to here. I don't know if they're gonna make it, but oh yeah, that's what I was gonna say when I was saying about the market season. Because Mother's Day weekend is the next Baker Creek event. And y'all know I'm gonna come home with a bunch more plants from there too. So yeah. Cause that's just how I roll. So I think we got all of our stuff started. Is there anything else in there? Nope. So got all of our plants started. And then the ones that I got from David the Good's tent, I'm not sure if I'm gonna plant them right away. They really don't need to be. They're certainly not too large for the pots. These ones have plenty of time to grow in these pots. I'm just gonna leave them outside. Hopefully they will recover from my dumb self leaving them in a bag for 2 weeks, for a week and a half. But if not, I'll be picking some more up. Dang it. Why do I do this to myself all the time? I knew I needed to do something about them and I did not. I could have at least taken them out of a bag, like just thrown them, literally just put them in a pot and they would have been much better off. I need to go lock up the chickens. I need to get these guys a little bit of water because I did not pre-water that soil before I put it in the pots. So I'm gonna go ahead and do all of that and then I will see you guys back here for the next video where we're going to be up potting like crazy and doing a little bit more garden prep because I need to prep the area for the tomatoes. So I hope you guys enjoy. Thanks for coming along with me. If you guys missed the speech that I gave at the Keepers of the Old Ways, check out this video right here. It is all kinds of inspiring fermentation, abundance of knowledge. At least I think so. Anyways, peace out, sauerkraut.